Hello, everybody. I'm Leora Sims. Welcome to my channel, and welcome to Season 1, Part 18 of my Sims 4 Law and Order SVU series. If you missed any of the other episodes, please go back and watch them. Before I get back into gameplay today, I'm going to be telling you part of a story. I will be telling you the other part in another video on a different topic, because this experience saved my life so much, and I realized that the story has two distinct points. I have a master's degree in nonprofit management. After I received that degree, I went to work for a nonprofit that was designed to find employment for people with disabilities and with degrees, which is very rare. It's very rare to find an organization that is designed to help disabled people with degrees find jobs. It's sad, but it's true. And I will get back to that in another video, as I said. While I was working there, I helped a young woman get an internship and a job. One day, I walked into my supervisor's office, and she was speaking to a young woman. This young woman wanted to get an internship, which would lead to a full-time position at a company. And my supervisor was trying to train her on how to interview. She would say things like, if the interviewer asks you A, B, and C, how will you answer? And this young woman answered my supervisor the way she intended to answer her interviewer. And I turned around and I said, I'm sorry. I don't want to be in your business, but you will not get this position if you answer that way. What do you want to say? And the reason I said that is because this young woman was coming off, for lack of better terms, snooty, snobby, and entitled. And demanding. And I have a talent of putting things in the right words. I remember once when I was in high school, a young woman came up to me and told me that she had a major crush on this boy, that she loved him and she would love him forever, and she could not speak to him. She could not express herself, and she did not know how she was going to do it, and she wanted me to write something, write him a love poem for her. And I said to her, tell me how you feel about this boy. I will then take the information that I gathered, repeat it to you, ask you if that's how you feel, and then based on what I gathered, once it is correct, once it is describing how you feel, I will write a poem based on that. And I did that, and she gave the poem to the boy. And for all I know, they could be married today. I'm not quite sure. But the boy loved the poem, and she said that she wrote the poem. And I didn't care. I was happy to help her. So I asked this woman, who was training for the interview, what she really wanted to say in answer to question A, question B, question C, and so on. And she told me, and I told her a more polite way to say what she wanted to say. And I also told her that I understood her. And I will tell you why I told her that I understand her. She has a disability. A disability that people can see. And many times, if you have a disability and you are quiet, people look past you. So you have to be, at least in my experience as a disabled person, you have to be proactive. You have to exude confidence. Even if that's not how you feel, you have to exude confidence because that is how people see past the disability oftentimes. I have a friend who is very loud, and I say that with love. It works for her that she's loud. I'm not insulting her in any way. She's in a wheelchair and she's loud. So people hear her before they see her. So they judge her on her voice and the way she speaks. And the way she speaks works for her. And the way she speaks tells people that she is very smart. And as I said, they hear her voice before they see the chair. So they don't treat her like she's, for lack of a better term, stupid. I hate the word stupid. But I feel that as a disabled person, people often think that I'm stupid. And my friend does not get a lot of that because she speaks before she is seen. So this young woman who was being trained for the interview wanted to exude confidence. She acted like a person that would throw a fit if she didn't get the job. She didn't say please. She didn't say thank you. I told her that she had to say please and thank you at the beginning and the end of the interview. And she looked at my supervisor after I gave her a little bit of training. And my supervisor said, I couldn't say it any better than Leora is saying it right now. Listen to Leora. Leora, keep going. And I told her how to politely interview for for this position. And still be assertive. Because she wanted to appear as she was, capable. And as I said in another video, many times people look at me and just assume that I'm not capable. So I understand her fear, and I understand why she came in demanding, because she wants to show that she is not only good for the job, but she is better than everybody else. She was trying to compete, and she was doing a good job. And what was going to stop her from getting the position was bad manners. I told her bad manners and misconception. I told her that she may get the internship, but the goal was to be offered a full-time position. She was probably going to get the internship because there weren't that many people applying and they wanted someone with a disability. But I was concerned that after the 3-month period, they would let her go because they wouldn't be able to work with her. If you work in an office, you have to know how to talk to people and how to work with people. And she wasn't giving off that vibe. She did get the internship, and yes, she did get offered a full-time position, which she took. And weeks later, I was sitting at my desk. She came into the office and was talking on her cell phone. And I heard her say, please and thank you. And I was very happy. I think that she was talking to a dispatcher, trying to get a ride. But I was very happy that I helped her. And I was very happy that she was using the terms please and thank you. Because saying please and thank you in your daily life can go a long way. And she did thank me for my help. And my supervisor told me that I really helped her. And that I believe she thought that I was making the job easier for this young woman because this young woman took my pointers and ran with them. So it's important in a job interview to come off confident, but not come off like you're entitled. And not come off as threatening. But again, I understand the impulse because so many people with disabilities are looked over. And people with disabilities want to be seen. And they want things to be fair. Just like everybody else. They want to be given a chance. So if you have an opportunity to hire somebody with a disability, please give them a chance. Because people with disabilities are very capable and are often not given a fair chance. Sometimes all anybody needs is a chance to prove themselves. And that's what this young woman was trying to do. She was trying to prove herself. And I've told you that when I was in school, I was very competitive. I felt like I couldn't just be a good student. I had to be the best student because I had to prove that I was better. And that's the attitude that this young woman was displaying before she was trained on how to do a proper interview. And I think what helped her listen to my pointers was the fact that I explained that I understood where she was coming from. I hope that this video helps you. Be happy, and I will be right back. Olivia is currently working, talking to a witness to a crime. And now she's going to collect some evidence. First she's going to take a picture. Then she's going to collect evidence sample.
Boom.
Jabini noe biyarmish.
Eno planar.
Bavosi.
Oh, jargon de cool.
Zalka.
Horny patoza bab.
Ubarig lire.
Kamiox.
Yefid me.
Yibs.
Rhombus. Niaflu. Yamasani. Thanks, sir.
She's having a very stressful day as.
Tarbahe barbina.
Finoy cho.
Orbital.
Betsy.
And we'll see if this gentleman will.
Oh, cardool.
Talk to us, and he will.
We'll
take a report from him.
Yes, Nar. Kulay. Kubreg.
Shunik laba arbe. Uibak dutsu o. Dol bay. Jay. Bikfoya slap. Wadiga. Abrupt banar.
Songzo.
Muma.
Efate.
Jabi. Finey spino. Yef to me kiss. Whips drift swing. And a.
Conclusion. Nimenu.
Spinaya Froze.
Frinzoi. Trossip Sapin. Omaga Kupatan. Wibasu.
Ah, body.
Skuma Pony. Jessine Konkas. Lanaga. Ha ha ha.
Clap ate Brenatu. Big boy. A pleva. Yeah, sure, sure. Griffin, new play. Tribna.
I see Bumparo. Some PC with Sabu Shusha.
So you're trying to collect or get another witness statement. I'm gonna have her collect a sample. Take a statement from. Oh, this gentleman looks like he could have been here during the time of the crime.
Sway be de bishi to
you. Yep. Bremul karipi. Jake.
Black, black, black.
Uh-huh.
I will be right back. Olivia is here at City Park after a stressful day. She decided that she wanted to come to the park to unwind with her friend, ADA Raphael Barba, as well as Detective Amanda Rollins and Amanda's toddler daughter, Jessie. So they're going to go here together. Where's Jessie? There she is. I'm always scared that the toddlers won't follow. And Olivia, who has always been good with children, is going to change Jessie's diaper and she's going to brighten her day. I wanted Olivia to actually teach her how to say please and thank you, but it might be a good idea if Jessie learns to talk first. Although I think I was saying thank you and please it too, according to my mother. To read her a book.
Pinkuba Koiba? Yes.
Rollins is gonna run off and do something fun while she has the chance.
Oh, Mullabide.
Raphael is on his phone.
Oh, yes.
That actually looks very accurate.
Larkem, Moosh, Brapna, Gweevy, Bazoo, Grovel, Nerx, Deree.
Olivia did get her promotion.
Honka, Bazee, Wisset, Borb.
She made 328 simoleons today. And Olivia was a detective on Law & Order SVU for a very long time. So I would like to say that she just added to her rank today. She's still a detective in my book. Going to play with Jessie, and then she's going to try to make Raphael Barba laugh like only she can. when The Sims 4 Seasons comes out, I will be adding a swing to this park, as well as other parks that I've built.
Delso, Tribs, Eva, Bazig, Bazoor, Rick.
And I'll let you know when that's up on the gallery.
Yana Zorful, Wahoo Quad, Smooth. Tariq, B. Ralph, Illinois.
Pinkuba Koiba?
Oh, Ed is calling. I got the scoop that some crazy party is happening at the Bluffs right now. Wanna check it out? No, wanna have a quiet night, Ed. Sorry.
Yes.
She's going to teach Jesse how to talk. She's flipping through the toddler book. That's so cute.
Nibor, Yavoba.
Oh.
Shazaluparim, Pasaga Alamine.
And she's going to have a deep conversation with Raphael Barba. Because why not?
Mebuv Mokosa, Holy Night. Fenuza, Fenuza. Wasoda lo yin with the sumaiba. Mebuf mokosa, holy night. Shiben miploy, yaban zaluzis. Yokip, habini ishi, join gionyiva. Chimere jabin slawfish.
Ina planar.
Jabin.
Oh, jarbin decool. Jabin. Nobi Yermta, Janabe, Jovi, Nobi Flurba,
Ebony Flurba, Befete Pelka, Kumiao Bouchard Sposhim,
Twain Sharpen, Dugas and Bar, Zorb, Baby Punka, Dirty Sleuth, Vula Epni, Shibi Merkib, Mola,
and with that, I'm ending this episode here. I hope that you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed bringing it to you. I hope that you found some of my information helpful to you. And understand and know that at the bottom of each of these episodes, there is a link to the Joyful Heart Foundation in case you need to get in touch with them for any help. Be happy.